Thank you, Madam Chairman. I'm trying to break this down and so to understand as Americans, we recycle about 90% of the car batteries that we use. And it makes sense, you know, I mean, you get $10 usually a core charge, you bring it back and it's big and heavy and bulky, you don't want it laying around your house. And then when I grew up, we used to recycle pop bottles at 2 cents a piece. And well, it was 2 cents when I got started. Anyway, we did pretty good on that. And I keep thinking about that. We have 3 billion a year of the disposable batteries we use in our flashlights or our little, you know, and we don't do anything with them. We just throw them away. And then now all the new age we got coming in with cars and wind power and solar power, home, the big storage batteries, we're not doing any of that. Like, throw away cars now? Is that the way they look at it? I mean, can an average person that owns an electric car change that battery? There has to be something that we do here, because I keep thinking of all my environmental friends who, you know, are rightfully right on top and looking at everything that we do, and coal mining is something that's scrutinized every minute of every day of how it's done, the energy it's produced, the steel that it's produced, the ability for us to win every war we've been in because of our own energy supply. But when we talk about clean energy, you're telling me that clean energy is the dirtiest form of energy we have right now, what it takes to produce what we look at as clean. So I guess out of sight, out of mind for Americans, we're happy with that as long as someone else is using child labor and doing the dirty work. Sooner or later, our environmental friends have got to step to the front and push this. It won't be pushed unless we pass some legislation on mandatory recycling. If you make that battery, you're responsible for it if you're a car manufacturer that has to be used. So would that cut down a great deal on the amount of mining that's needed to be done for these rare earth minerals? Is there enough that we can extract from recycling to really change a whole boom? And I would think you have a little bit of an incentive, a financial incentive that goes a long way in Americans' habits. So, Mr. Kang, you might want to, since you're in this business.
Sir, again, I would say that recycling is one answer to meet the demands that we see in the future. I believe that by having a robust collection system and a vibrant recycling industry, we not only will meet the national security issues that we're discussing here today, but will also be, as you mentioned, taking care of a hazardous problem where
Who changes the car batteries right now? If I have an electric car, I know my good friend, Senator from New Mexico here, Senator Heinrich, has a beautiful little electric car, and so does Senator King. Who's going to change your battery?
It is the automobile manufacturer.
So
when it's under warranty. So let's think about
how about that. It's not under warranty?
Well,
battery goes dead.
Then you would have mechanics and you know, automobile shops that would.
It'd be hard for Martin to do it. I mean, for Senator Heinrich.
Absolutely.
To do it himself.
Okay. That's correct.
Okay, how about in the house if I have solar panels, and those are pretty good heavy-sized batteries, am I capable of doing the replacement, or do I usually have a contract with a company that services that?
Correct, I would believe
so. So you already have a built-in mechanism for those people to have 100% recycling, correct?
If we can utilize the infrastructures that are in place today, the service contractors that install and can remove. Also, the waste.
But there's no laws whatsoever that mandate that we recycle these.
I'm sorry?
How are they disposing? Just in landfills?
Currently,
does
yes.
Does car go to landfill or just a battery in a car?
Well, there are conversations today from automobile manufacturers looking at the end of life of these electric vehicle batteries. I think they are, you know, coming together, again, because it's also a collection issue and how to, you know, streamline these. But again, we need to, you know, invest into the recycling industry to create a solution for these batteries to be taken care of. And so if this committee can work on incentivizing this industry, I will tell you, it's for the past several years, the conversation has definitely changed in terms of investing into the recycling of lithium-ion batteries. But it has been difficult. I watched the testimony and hearing prior to this one, and I believe it was there was some information that recycling of lithium-ion batteries is not an economically viable industry. And I would say that it is actually for our company, and we see the value there, and we can find value. So the technology is there. the industry can thrive, and we need it. We need the industry.
Yeah, Mr. Mills, very quickly, you made some comments earlier. I was interesting in as far as where we're getting, how we're sourcing, what we're doing, what our mental state may be. Do you have anything you want to add to that?
Well, I think I would just remind the committee of the scale issue we're talking about. So recycling cell phone batteries, you know, it's a 400 million cell phones, a billion, I think, now a year sold. But the scale involved in storing energy in automobiles and grids is, to use the overused word, astronomically greater. So the challenge is not just that one could recycle. Recycling has limits. They're economic, they're practical, they're physical. We should do more.
Let me ask this question. Is the environmental community, and really, and I have some great friends in that, and bring it to our attention, they come and see our office and tell us what's going on. This is the first time I've heard of the amount of social changes and basically things that we thought we eliminated 50 years or more ago, child labor, environmental laws, and you know, and we're letting the Congo and everybody else just run rampant on this. How come they, I mean, has it not been brought to their attention? Do they see it along those lines?
There's a lot of, the Washington Post did an outstanding expose on the cobalt issue. Mm-hmm. There are some good investigative journalists that still in the world, despite the challenges of the industry. And when you look at the supply chain, both in environmental terms and in labor terms, most countries are not as sensitive to doing it right as we are. Most of the mining is migrating there. A lot of the nickel in the world is produced in Russia. I worked for a mining company in Canada earlier in my career, maybe the only person in this room, perhaps, that's been at the bottom of a 5,000-foot vertical hard rock shaft, mined silver, gold, and uranium, and was very much involved in the reclamation and the environmental processes. But we don't, in the West and in Europe in particular, want to mine anymore. I mean, when I said there was an antipathy to it, that's what I find, not just in the environmental community, but among my colleagues, both conservative and liberal. They don't think we should mine in America. My position is that the world, with or without more clean energy, is going to need a lot more mine materials. To the senator from Arizona's point, it doesn't matter whether it's an air conditioner or a motor. You need copper, you're going to need nickel, steel, aluminum. Electric cars use more aluminum because you have to get them lighter because the batteries are heavy. They use more nickel. They use more common materials. Windmills use steel. We want iron ore to come from someplace other than Minnesota. I think these challenges of bringing them back here are addressable, but we have to mount a campaign that says, look, we can use automation, modern technologies, and monitoring to do mining very safely. The automation reduces the labor, but it actually increases the labor here because it'll bring the mining back here.
Thank you, Madam Chairman.